Let us continue with solutions with the next topic, solubility. Now, solubility will define first. It is defined as the maximum amount of a substance that we can dissolve in given quantity of the solvent at specific temperature. For example, if I dissolve, say, salt in 10 ml and 20 ml water, the amount dissolved will not be same. And the amount will also vary with temperature. We'll be talking about the factors that affect solubility of solid in liquid and gas in liquid. The first I'm talking about solid in liquid. There are four main factors which affect the solubility of solid in liquid. First, two factors are very much related to each other. It is nature of solute and solvent. It is mainly talking about nature of solute and solvent. We discuss in chemical bond that ionic compounds are more soluble in polar solvents and covalent compounds are more soluble in non-polar solvents. So definitely ionic compounds will be not soluble in non-polar, covalent will not be soluble in ionic. That means here we mainly refer to like dissolves like. The solubility of ionic will be more in polar solvent, likewise covalent in organic solvents. Third factor is temperature. Third factor is again related to Lee Chatelier's principle. Children, you remember you have studied in chemical equilibrium, Lee Chatelier's principle, the effect of temperature on the direction of the reaction. Like for exothermic or endothermic substances, the effect of temperature changes. If the compound, when dissolved in water, liberates heat, that means if it is exothermic, then the solubility will be more in at lower temperature. Likewise, for endothermic substances, the solubility will increase with temperature. I think you've got my point. For exothermic substances, the solubility decreases with increase in temperature. For endothermic substances, solubility increases with increase in temperature. For the solubility of solid and liquid, pressure has no effect. Because for the solids, we say that the intermolecular spaces are very less. The particles are tightly held, so the pressure will not have much effect on the solubility of solid and liquid. Now, first, let's talk about solubility of gas and liquid. For gas and liquid, the first two factors, nature of solute and solvent, doesn't affect much. The first two factors are not much applicable for this solubility of gas and liquid. There are two main factors which affect the solubility of gas and liquid, that is temperature and pressure. Solubility of gas and liquid is mainly exothermic. Therefore, the solubility decreases with the rise of temperature. You can quote here one application of it. Aquatic animals feel more comfortable in cold waters than in warm water. Because in cold water, the amount of oxygen dissolved in water will be more. So this is one of the applications of the solubility. The next is pressure. Solubility for gases in liquid is directly proportional to the pressure. So here we can have one law which quotes about it. There are two statements which we can give for Henry's law. Solubility of a gas in liquid is directly proportional to the partial pressure of the gas above the solution. I'll give you example for it also. Let me talk about the second statement, which says partial pressure of a gas in vapor phase is directly proportional to mole fraction of the gas in the solution. We take example of aerated drinks. In the bottle, over that aerated bottle, if the pressure of carbon dioxide is more, then more amount of the carbon dioxide can be dissolved in it. In a way, we can say that if you have a container The partial pressure of the gas over the solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the gas in the solution. That means more the partial pressure over, more will be the mole fraction in the solution. That is Henry's law. So mathematical form can be given, partial pressure is equal to KH into mole fraction. Partial pressure of what? The gas over the solution, mole fraction of the gas in the solution, and KH being Henry's law constant. So this is the formula for Henry's law. Partial pressure is KH into mole fraction, where KH is dependent on the nature of the gas. What different gases will have different KH value. That means it depends upon the size of the gas, intermolecular forces which are available in that particular gas. KH is inversely proportional to solubility. That means if more solubility is there, the KH value will be less. So if it is inversely proportional to solubility, definitely it will be directly proportional to temperature, because we discussed here that the solubility and temperature are inversely related. So for this, you can refer to this table in your NCERT textbook, table 2.2. Please go through this carefully. As per Henry's law, we can also plot a graph between partial pressure and mole fraction. Since they are directly proportional, you will get a straight line. There are certain applications of Henry's law. One, which I already discussed just now, aerated drinks, carbon dioxide, more pressure there, more will be the mole fraction in the solution. Scuba divers, you must have come across this. Scuba divers, when they go inside the sea, they carry the cylinders which contains air which is diluted with helium. This is the percentage which they carry in the oxygen in the cylinder. The reason being, when they go inside deep in the sea, the pressure is more. So more amount of nitrogen goes in their blood, and when they suddenly come up, on the surface of sea, the excess of nitrogen which has gone into the blood doesn't come out of their blood easily. So bubbles of nitrogen are formed in their blood. This condition is called as bend. It's very painful. More amount of nitrogen bubbles, if they are formed, it can even lead to death. Mountaineers, this also you must have heard, when mountaineers climb up the mountain, they are not able to get good amount of oxygen, because the pressure is less. When the pressure is less, the solubility of air in their blood also will be less, so they feel breathless, low thinking. That condition is called as anoxia, which leads to low thinking and breathlessness in the people. There is one more law which we will be talking about after this, is Raoult's law. Actually speaking, Henry's law and Raoult's law are reverse of each other. Let me first define Raoult's law. It says partial vapor pressure of component over the solution is directly proportional to mole fraction present in the solution. Henry's law says more the partial pressure here, more will be the mole fraction which is going to dissolve inside. Raoult's law says more the mole fraction here, more will be the vapor formed. So more will be the vapor pressure created. So that means the two laws, they are related to each other but in the opposite direction. This talks about pressure getting dissolved, more the gas here, more the mole fraction. This talks about more the mole fraction, more the pressure created.